In today's session on concrete technology and reinforced concrete part 2, let us discuss under concrete mix design the need for design of concrete mix, the factors affecting design and the methods of mix design, and also the methods of preparing concrete mix and loads to be considered and for the design of structural elements and the methods of RC structural elements. As discussed in our previous sessions, reinforced concrete is a composite material which consists of a concrete and steel as a reinforcement. Wherever structural element is subjected to compressive stresses, concrete takes care of these compressive stresses, whereas when the members are subjected to tensile stresses, reinforcement, steel as a reinforcement takes care of tensile stresses. As far as the strength and quality of reinforcement is concerned, steel is a homogeneous material and is manufactured under controlled conditions in factory, and the strength of steel remains almost up to the requirement as we mentioned in our designs. So the quality and strength of steel has got not much concern, whereas when it comes to a concrete itself is a composite material made of many different ingredients. So concrete, which is made up of different materials, different ingredients, and it is made at the site under uncontrolled conditions, it will have variable strength qualities. So in the design of reinforced concrete elements, the quality of steel is not much worried about, but the concrete has to be taken care of, as the quality of one concrete varies as the different ingredients are involved in preparation of concrete. And in today's session, as the concrete has got lot of variability in its strength, in its quality, see, let us try to discuss more about the concrete and the variability that are involved in the strength requirements of concrete under the title concrete mix design. So concrete mix design takes into account the widely varying properties of ingredients of concrete, the conditions prevailing at site of work, and the conditions that are demanded for particular type of work. So the widely varying properties of ingredients of concrete, so what is it? So concrete is a composite material made up of the ingredients, that is the coarse aggregate, the fine aggregate, cement and water. So each of these ingredients have got their own variability in their properties, and each property of these ingredients have to be taken care of while concrete mix is to be designed for its strength requirements. Then the conditions prevailing at site of work. So the concrete mix which we design in the control conditions of laboratory may not suit to the site requirements, site conditions, as the site of work may have different conditions, and due to which reason the quality of concrete may change. And the conditions that are demanded for a particular type of work. So depending upon the nature of work, the concrete has to be designed for its strength, as the different different works like the structural elements related to high-rise buildings, structural elements related to the road works or the huge concrete works. The nature of work involved in structural concreting also has got impact on the variability in quality in characteristics of concrete. Now, mixed design is the process of selecting suitable ingredients of concrete and determine their relative proportions, producing concrete of certain minimum strength, durability, and as economical as possible. So, the mixed design is that process in which the concrete ingredients or the proportion of ingredients in concrete are determined for producing the required strength of concrete and also the durability, okay, taking into consideration the economy of the construction. Concrete widely classified into the aggregates and cement paste, where strength of concrete mainly depends on cement paste, since aggregates are far stronger than cement paste. In design of reinforced concrete, it is required to specify the properties of the hardened concrete. So, in the design of RC elements, designer has to specify the properties of hardened concrete. That means, after the completion of the process of curing, the concrete has to provide the necessary strength requirement for which the element has been designed. So, this happens after 28 days of concreting the element. So, a designer provides or specifies the properties of hardened concrete for 28 days and for which the concrete has to be designed. The concrete is known by its grade and is designated as M20, M25, etc., in which M refers to mix and the number to its characteristic strength in axial compression at 28 days on 150 mm³ expressed in Newton per mm square. So, the strength of concrete specified by the designer is by the grade of concrete, that is in terms of M20, M25, M30, etc., where M stands for the mix, the concrete mix, and the number or the numerical value that refers to the characteristic strength of concrete in axial compression at 28 days. So, the grade of concrete that is mentioned as in form of M is the one which specifies the conditions for which a concrete has to be designed, and this depends upon the exposure conditions to which the concrete element has to be at the working site. So, what are the exposure conditions for which the concrete is subjected to? So, as per IS 456-2000, the exposure conditions are mild conditions when concrete surface protected against weather. So, if the structural elements are protected against weather, we consider the structure to be under the exposed conditions called mild conditions, and the concrete surface sheltered from heavy rain but saturated with water and buried in soil continuously under water. This is the condition which for which if concrete element is exposed, then we consider it as moderate condition. Then if the concrete element is exposed to seawater and alternate wetting and drying, exposed to corrosive fumes, then we consider the concrete to be exposed to severe exposure conditions. There are certain more conditions, exposure conditions, which are mentioned in IS 456-2000, which will be taken into account depending upon different places where the elements are to be designed. And based on these exposure conditions, we take into consideration the grade of concrete to be used. Now, minimum grade of concrete suggested for RCC work for different exposures are, if the exposure is mild, exposure condition is mild, then M20 grade, minimum of M20 grade concrete has to be used. And if the exposure condition is moderate, then minimum of M25 grade concrete has to be used. And for more severe conditions, the grade of concrete to be used is M30. This is as per table 5 of IS 456-2000. Now, depending upon the exposure conditions and the strength requirements, the design engineer specifies the grade of concrete based on the conditions of exposure, and it is the responsibility of site engineer to produce concrete of required strength and durability. So, how is it possible? How to achieve this? How to achieve a concrete of required strength and durability? That is the point where we have to put lot of concentration. Now, this is achieved by proportioning the ingredients of concrete so that fresh concrete has workability and hardened concrete has desired strength, durability and surface finish. So, concrete which is designed for casting the elements has to satisfy certain requirements in its fresh state and hardened state. So, in a fresh state, concrete is expected to be workable. So, what is the meaning of workability? So, workability is that property of concrete by which concrete can be easily mixed, transported, placed and compacted, and finally to get the structural element to its required form. So, by achieving the proportions of ingredients of concrete, see, concrete should be workable in its fresh state. And after 28 days of curing period, concrete gets hardened and it has to attain its desired strength and durability and surface finish. So, the durability of concrete means it has to provide the service for which it is meant for, and the strength is for the purpose of taking loads for which the concrete element is designed, and the surface finish is that due to which the element appears to be in a condition for which it is designed. Now, proportioning of the constituting materials, that is cement, aggregate and water, to attain the required strength is done in the following ways. So, by adopting the nominal concrete mix, the concrete is called nominal mixed concrete. So, nominal mixed concrete is that in which the proportioning of ingredients is done just by experience or without going through the scientific methods of calculations and without taking into consideration the various properties of ingredients that are used in it. So, by past experience, so the nominal mix can be selected, and nominal mix concrete can be prepared. By designing concrete mix, concrete which we prepare, we call it as design mix concrete. Proportions of nominal concrete mix can be obtained from table 9 of IS 456-2000 for the grades from M5 to M20. So, as the nominal mix concrete doesn't involve any scientific methods of calculations and the properties of ingredients are not taken into account, this nominal mix can be used only for the grades of concrete between M5 to M20, which are lower grades of concrete. And for the purpose of guidance, the proportions of ingredients of nominal mix concrete can be had from table 9 of IS 456-2000. Nominal mix is used only for concretes of grade M20 and lower, and design mix is always preferred to nominal mix. Design mix concrete. The scientific method based on experiments and past experience to determine the proportions of ingredients of concrete such that the mix is workable in fresh state and has required strength and durability in its hardened state is known as mix design method. So, the mix design involves the scientific methods based on the experiments conducted on the materials or the ingredients involved in the mix design, and with the past experience, certain assumptions can be made in design of concrete mix, and finally, the product which we get out of this process should have been workable in fresh state and should have strength and durability in its hardened state. So, such a concrete mix is called design concrete mix. The concrete thus produced is called design mix concrete. Now, methods of mix design. You can see the various methods that are available in the design of concrete mix. The American Concrete Institute method, the United States Bureau of Reclamation method, British mix design method, which is under the Department of Environment, and Indian standard method. So, you can see in each and every method, the various places or the countries that are involved, because the concrete mix is the one which is to be which is prepared at site, made suitable to the conditions that are prevailing at site. So, for different countries follow different methods of concrete mix design. And as far as our discussion is concerned, let us try to discuss the Indian standard method of concrete mix design. Now, before specifying particular grade of concrete, the following information is required. That is, type of mix. The type of mix means the design mix or nominal mix. For ordinary works, we may go for nominal mix. Selecting grades starting from M5 to M20, and for elements that are involved with high quality of work and subjected to heavy loads, etc., the design mix concrete has to be selected. Then grade of designation. So, depending upon the exposure conditions of the element, we have to select the grade designation, whether it is for M20, M25 or M30. So, grade designation is another important particular that is required before we go for concrete mix design. Then, minimum cement content. Concrete mix should have minimum amount of cement quantity of cement in it. So how much, what should be the minimum cement content depending upon the grade of concrete should also be taken into account. This is for mix design mix concrete. And type of cement, depending upon the type of cement also certain values to be considered in the design of concrete mix changes. So type of cement should also be mentioned before going for concrete mix design. Then minimum nominal size of aggregate. So depending upon the structural element which we are designing, we have to select the maximum nominal size of aggregate. And depending upon the nominal size of aggregate, we take into account the different values and steps in the design of concrete mix. Then maximum water cement ratio, this is very very important because the strength, durability and surface finish of the concrete elements depends on water cement ratio along with the workability of concrete in its fresh state. So maximum water cement ratio that can be applied, used for the particular grade of concrete in the design of concrete mix should also be taken into consideration, which will be available in IS code IS 456 2000. Then mix proportion for nominal mix concrete, the mix proportion is also to be mentioned if the design is to be a nominal mix concrete. And the workability, workability is another important property of concrete to be taken into consideration, and it is mentioned in so many, in many ways, normally in form of slump to be allowed or in the form of compaction factor to be taken into account for the purpose of design of concrete mix. Now Indian standard method of design of concrete mix, this method is also covered in IS 1026-1982 recommended guidelines for concrete mix design. And this book made by Indian Standard Institution provides all the necessary information that is required, you know, for the design of concrete mix design. And certain charts and tables have been developed and incorporated in this book as a guideline for concrete mix design, and it gives you, gives us all the necessary information about the various values or steps to be involved in the design of concrete mix. Now what is the data required for mix design? Number one, the characteristic compressive strength of concrete at 28 days. So what is this characteristic compressive strength of concrete at 28 days? So any element that is designed for different loads should provide certain strength. And depending upon this strength, the size of the element is to be designed. And the strength of this element should always be maintained or taken into consideration such a way that throughout its life period of the element, the concrete should have the specified strength. So characteristic compressive strength of concrete at 25 days is that value of the strength of material below which not more than 5% of test results are expected to fall. So out of 100 test specimens tested for compression, only 5% can have the results lower than what is required in the design of the structural element. So this characteristic compressive strength of concrete at 28 days is essential for designing of concrete mix design. Then degree of workability, this is degree of workability of concrete can be taken from the clause 7.1 of IS 456 2000. then limitations of water cement ratio and minimum cement content to ensure durability. So water cement ratio has got a very important role in the design of concrete mix, and also the minimum cement content in the design of concrete mix to ensure the durability, which have to be taken from the table of IS 456-2000. Then type of maximum size of aggregate to be used, the type and maximum size of aggregate to be used. So type of aggregate and maximum size of aggregate is also essential for the purpose of considering the certain values in the steps involved in the design of concrete mix design. Then standard deviation of compressive strength of concrete, which is available in table 8 of IS 400-2000. The standard deviation is the value which is taken from the table for the purpose of taking into account the variability of properties of concrete after completing the concrete mix design. And in addition to this, a test data for materials is also important. So what are the test data of materials? Before we design concrete mix, see, the following tests have to be conducted in the laboratory, and the necessary values have to be taken into account to be used in the design of concrete mix. So under the test data for materials, the concrete should have the cement, the type of cement should be mentioned. Then specific gravity of cement and coarse and fine aggregate has to be mentioned. Then water absorption of coarse and fine aggregate has to be mentioned. Then free moisture content of coarse and fine aggregate has to be mentioned, and grading of aggregate conforming to IS 383-1970 has to be mentioned. The free moisture content of coarse and fine aggregate is available in table 10 of IS 400. Now design steps of concrete mix. Determine the target strength using the values of characteristic compressive strength and standard deviation. So the target strength of concrete has to be calculated using the formula FCK bar is equal to FCK plus T into S, where FCK bar is target strength in Newton per mm square, FCK the characteristic compressive strength at 28 days, and T a statistical value usually 1.65, and S is a standard deviation. So the target strength is the value which is for which the concrete mix has to be designed to get a characteristic compressive strength of concrete at 28 days. So for an element to be designed for using M20 grade concrete, then 20 is the numerical value which takes into account the characteristic compressive strength, and the T is the statistical value which depends on the definition of characteristic strength of concrete. And for RCC elements present discussion, it is 1.65, and S is the standard deviation which can be had from the tables available in IS 456. Then determine water cement ratio for the target strength, which is available in table 5 of IS 456-2000. Then select the water content and sand from the tables conforming to coarse of aggregate, and this is widely available in IS 1026-1982, which gives the guidelines for concrete mix design. Then determine the cement content from water cement ratio and final water content arrived after adjustment. Compare the minimum content from durability consideration. So having known the water cement ratio and the minimum cement to be minimum content of cement that is required in the design of concrete mix, we can calculate the cement content from the water cement ratio, and then the quantity of sand can be calculated from after applying the necessary adjustments that are accounted for different purposes. Then determine the quantities of coarse and fine aggregate using the following equations, where the equation involves V, the volume, bulk volume of fresh concrete equal to gross volume minus value of entrapped air, then the W, mass of water in kgs per unit volume of concrete, then specific gravity of cement, mass of cement in kgs per unit volume of concrete, then mass of fine aggregate in kgs per cubic meter, mass of coarse aggregate in kgs per cubic meter, then P is the ratio of fine aggregate to total aggregate, SCA is the specific gravities of saturated, surface dry, fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. So by involving all these values, volume of cement concrete, the cement concrete is calculated, and based on that, using the equations that are mentioned just now, and the ingredients are calculated in their proportions, and finally the actual quantities of water to be added after making corrections for water absorption by aggregates and free moisture present in the aggregate. So actual quantities of ingredients and water to be added to it is calculated after applying the necessary adjustments or corrections depending upon the requirements. Then let us go through quickly the example on concrete mix design. The design data contains character strength of concrete FCK equal to 30 Newton per square, maximum size aggregate 20 mm, the workability, degree of workability is medium, compaction factor 0.85 to 0.92 or 25 to 60 mm slump, and degree of quality control good, type of exposure mild. So the test results that are to be taken into account are the type of cement used in this particular example. It is OPC, then specific gravity of cement 3.15, specific gravity of coarse aggregate 2.6 and fine aggregate 2.6, water absorption of coarse aggregate 0.5% and fine aggregate 1%, free surface moisture of coarse aggregate 1% and fine aggregate 2%, and the coarse and fine aggregate are conforming to the code. Then in the first step, for calculating target strength, the formula which we apply is FCK equal to FCK plus T into S, wherein the necessary values are substituted and the target strength of the concrete is calculated. Then water cement ratio against target strength of 38.25 square is 0.375, which is selected from the curves that are available in IS 10262 1982. Then entrapped air per 20 mm maximum size of aggregates is taken as 4% as per the clause 8.2.2.3 of IS 456 2000. So this entrapped air may cause change in volume of concrete, and hence this is very much important for the purpose of concrete mix design. For the given workability required, sand content P and water content W is calculated as per tables of IS 10262 1982 as 29% and 188.79 liters per meter cube of concrete. Then cement content C is calculated based on the minimum cement requirement and water cement ratio. Then quantities of coarse and fine aggregates is calculated using a formula mentioned in equation number 1 and equation number 2, and by substituting the various values in the formulae, see the fine aggregate and coarse aggregate, quantity of fine aggregate and coarse aggregate is calculated, and finally the mixed proportion is calculated based on the quantities that are found for from the different steps that are involved in the concrete mix design. Then final mix proportion can be calculated applying correction for free moisture content in coarse and fine aggregate. So like this, we design a concrete for required strength at 28 days of curing period, and we design the concrete for its durability, for its lifetime service, and we design the concrete mix for workability when it is in fresh state. So having designed the concrete mix and arrived at the values that are required as an ingredients in their required proportion, so how to produce a concrete, what are the methods involved in the production of concrete? So production of concrete involves batching of materials and mixing of concrete. So batching of material is nothing but weighing or measuring the quantities of ingredients either by mass or by volume. So to measure the quantities by weighing, cement is available at a standard weight of 50 kgs per bag, and based on that, depending upon the proportions, the remaining ingredients, that is coarse aggregate, fine aggregate and water, can be weighed as a by taking into consideration any method that is available for weighing the ingredients. By volume, if a concrete, a batching of material has to be done, then a standard box of standard dimensions is used, which takes one bag of cement into it, and if one bag of cement can be taken in a box of standard dimensions, then based on that, depending upon the necessary proportions, the coarse aggregate and fine aggregate can be measured by volume, and the water can also be measured by volume and mixed together. Then what are the methods of mixing of concrete? Mixing of concrete can be done in two different methods, that is hand mixing and machine mixing. Hand mixing involves the mixing of concrete manually. So initially the sand and cement are mixed in dry state, and then the coarse aggregate is added to it, and finally water of required amount is added to the mix, and it is the concrete mix is made manually by mixing all the ingredients together, and as the mixing is done, it should be observed that the cement paste surrounds each and every aggregate, the particle of aggregates, and the mix is done uniformly. Then machine mixing is done by rotating drums, and depending upon the capacity of these rotating drums, all the ingredients are added to the placed in the rotating drum, and depending upon the quantity of concrete to be mixed, the required amount of time is maintained and required number of revolutions are maintained, and after completing the number of revolutions that is required to prepare a homogeneous concrete, the concrete is removed from the drums and used for the purpose of casting the elements. Then what are the loads on RCC structures to be taken into account? These are the loads on RCC structural elements are calculated as per IS 875-1984, and the code is available in 5 parts, starting from part 1 to part 5. Then the major loads that which we take into account are dead load, live load and wind load. Dead load involves the self weight of the member and the partitions that are to be supported by the member and any other structural elements that are going to remain permanently on the structural on the structure are considered to be dead loads. Then live loads are those which are movable. The load may remain for some time and may disappear after some time, depending upon the nature of the load. So live loads are those which may not remain permanently on the structural elements, and wind loads are those which act on structural elements due to the blow of wind. And these are wind loads are taken into account only for huge structures, very tall structures, and depending upon the places where it is situated, that is, for example, the coastal areas where strong wind is possible to be there, the structural elements or the design of structural elements, wind load may also be taken into account. And the minor loads which we come across are the snow load, the seismic load and erection load. These loads, depending upon the place where the members are to be designed or structure has to be designed, depending upon the conditions prevailing there, the snow load, seismic load or erection loads will be taken into account for the purpose of in the design of RCC structures. And finally, the methods involved in the design of RCC elements are the working stress method, the ultimate load method and limit state method. These methods are followed depending upon the various philosophies to be followed by a design engineer. And method of design that is required in the design of particular structural element depends on so many different theories. So with this, let us come to an end of this session. So before the end of the session, let me discuss that in the present session we have seen the design of concrete mix for its workability, the durability, strength and surface finish, and we have also discussed the steps involved, methods involved in the design of concrete mix and the loads that are expected on the RC structural elements and the methods of design of RC structural elements.